Hey there, it's Kelly from the Art Gallery of Hamilton in-class program. Are you ready to get started? So I have the beginning of an example of the project that we are going to work on together. And I would like to show you how I made this. So here are some of the materials that you're going to need. You're going to need a piece of cardboard, and it's about 12 centimeters by 22 centimeters, but it's not specific. You can make it roughly that size. You'll need some yarn or string. Here's another kind of yarn. Or maybe you'd like to try this idea. I made this out of an old t-shirt. What I ended up doing is I have an old t-shirt. It had paint all over it. And so I decided what I would do is I would cut strips off of it. So I started. And the strips are probably about 2 centimeters wide. I'm just going to cut a little bit of an example here so that you can see what you can do. And you could keep cutting, keep cutting, keep cutting. And so it looks kind of like this, right? If you pull it really tight like that, it rolls up. So it becomes almost like a cord. So that might be another thing. So I cut enough so that I could make a ball of it. All right, and so this is how we are going to create the loom. All right, so the string or the yarn or the cord that you make, these are going to become the warp. That's what you call the strings that you are go up and down on the loom. And how we do that, so you have your piece and you're going to measure centimeters. So to make our loom, what you need to do is take your ruler and measure 1 centimeter all along here. Right, and then I'm going to turn it around and I'm going to measure that 1 centimeter, mark the lines again. Okay, and then I take my scissors and I'm going to make some cuts, not too deep, probably again about another centimeter again. I'll put that on both ends. Okay, so there, this is our cardboard loom. And I'm gonna do it with the t-shirt cord just because I thought that was kind of a fun thing to try out. So the first thing you need to do is leave yourself about a 10 centimeter tail. And I'm gonna put it in the first notch, okay? Then I go straight down and I come around underneath and back up on top again. I don't wrap it around. It shouldn't be wrapping around. I want only to see it in the front on the brown part of the cardboard. So then I'm just going to, do this. Until I've got it wrapped all the way up and down. So these strings are called the warp. That's what we are going to weave into. The warp are the up and down strings on our loom. All right, when I get down to the end again, I leave about a 10 centimeter length. I'm gonna cut it. So you can see here is the front of the loom and here's the back of the loom, right? No strings on this side. So then I'm just going to take and I can tape these two down so that they don't come loose. All right, so we're going to set this aside just for a little bit, and we are going to figure out our plan for what we're going to weave into it. And what we weave into it is called our weft, W-E-F-T. So our weft is going to come crossways. Now, I remember that your story is set in the mall, right? And so that's where we're going to get our inspiration. And so thinking back to the colors that you assign to each character and to each location, I want you to go around the house looking for things you might weave into that work so we can represent the characters and the locations. And so I have a few examples. So I could cut strips from, this is a bag that the newspaper comes in. So here's it's kind of a clear blue. Do something like that. I have a bag, use a Best Buy bag, that's also blue. My milk bag, so that was this one here, right? So I cut the blue part out of there. So there's a color, so if you're looking for blue. I also pulled out my wrapping paper, and there's a couple of things that you can do with the wrapping paper. You can, like on here, this is an example of using the wrapping paper, right? So what I did is I cut a strip. And then to make it easier for weaving, what I did is I then folded it probably 3 times. So it ends up being about 1 centimeter thick when it's finished, and it means that you've got the color on both sides. So there, if you have wrapping paper, you could cut that up and turn that into something you could weave in. Oops, that one broke. Another thing, I was just looking around my kitchen and I found this onion bag, and I thought that might, when it collapses all together like that, really nice orange. I know they come in different colors, orange or yellow or green. So that might be something you could probably cut this so that you could get a couple of them. Probably doesn't need to be, just cut it in half even. And then you've got, you know, one piece and then another piece you could use in another later on. So there's some other things. What else? I went out in my yard. I thought we might try this. I haven't woven it into our project yet, but I thought I found some really long dandelions. Thought that might come in handy. And I have some ivy that grows in my garden. That might be kind of neat to weave in. We'll see. I'll try that out later. I also had some pipe cleaners. So maybe pipe cleaners might be something that you could use. And you can see that there's a real range of color, because what you want to do is find colors that represent each of the characters and each of the locations so that you can start to build your story, right? So here I started with a gray color, and how I got that is I got it with newspaper. So I just cut strips of newspaper, and then this one here, I actually just started twisting it. It was a little tricky, so you can try twisting it or you can try the folding method that I used with the colored, with the wrapping paper. But I thought it might be kind of fun to try and twist the newspaper. So I did it like that. So you kind of have to crunch it a little bit. And then once I've crunched it, I kind of twist it like this. Right, so that's, got some gray. If you're finding you're not getting the colors that you're looking for, if you wanted to take a marker and color some paper, you could do the same thing, make the color. If you're like, oh, I really need that special color of turquoise or something like that, you could make it yourself. So there we got another, we've got newspaper strips. There's more bags that so these are other colored bags. So I've got a gray bag or this Dollarama bag, so it's got white and green. Something else I tried was using a magazine. So this one, the cover is pretty heavy, so all I did was cut like a 1 centimeter. And that's, you can see that in here. That's that part right there where I used some of that garden color in there for that texture. All right, so that's the next thing you're going to do is you're going to go around the house and collect all these materials and have them ready so that when we meet the next time, we're actually going to be weaving our stories together. So that'll be your next job. I'm going to give you one more thing to do. All right, so the last step that you need to do to prepare for our class that we're going to be working on the project together when I'm live in your class is to prepare your story key. And so remember last time when I asked you to think of a color and for each character and each location? So now what you're going to do is you're going to look at all of those materials that you found that might be able to represent each of those characters and each of those locations, and we're going to create the story key. And the story key is what we'll use to retell the story. So if we're using the one that I made as an example, so if this is the beginning, right, and I started the gray, this was the gray interior, the gray, not very sunny day, the gray day that we were starting out with. So I'm going to start my story and I'm going to put a little bit of gray at the top. This is part of just so that you can remember, you can fill it in however you want. It doesn't have to be fully filled in. You can kind of just do it like that. And then I chose to add a lighter color of gray. So then maybe what I'll do, something like that. And then next was the red. Now that was pretty prominent. So I'm just gonna add some really strong red in there. Right. And then I have my green. So this is what you're going to do before you weave it. I'm only doing it after the fact so that I can show you the colors that I chose and how I spread them out. But you're going to do this in advance so that we can plan. And if you find that, you don't have something that's red, even though you have a character that you feel really is represented by red, then you need to continue to go look around your house or out in the yard or ask somebody, one of your friends, if they have anything that that you might be able to drop off at your house that is red. So we've got the blue, and then the last one is that little bit darker green. So I had that lighter green, and now I have that darker green. It's more like foliage, so I'm just gonna go kind of like that, and that's gonna represent that. So we're gonna continue ours all the way down. By the end of our time together, we'll have filled this whole thing, and we'll be able to retell the whole story that you've been working on that's set in the mall. And use your imagination. You can share your ideas with your friends as well in advance. So maybe they have an idea for a color or for a character, for a location, or maybe they have an idea of a material or something that you could use to weave into your project. It's all really about the idea of communicating and telling stories. So try and be as creative as possible and imaginative as possible. All right, so the next class, I'm going to be joining you live online, and so I'm really looking forward to that. So have fun looking for your materials and getting ready for our next time when we will weave together. All right, so see you next time.